Folks come in all the time to withdraw gold and turn around and lose it all betting on a game of tribute. Some big names, too. People you wouldn't believe. Oh, but I shouldn't say any more. What can I do for you? I know I won't have to look far to find a man who'd treat me better than my last husband. Oh, but I stand here all day looking at Chethkasi and... oh, it's enough to make a woman wonder. Oh, I'm sorry. What can I help you with today? know I won't have to look far to find a man who'd treat me better than my last husband. Oh, but I stand here all day looking at Chethkasi and... oh, it's enough to make a woman wonder. Oh, I'm sorry. What can I help you with today? My friend Hyduna wants to set me up with some old pirate that's been frequenting her inn. Can you imagine? A pirate and a banker! How ridiculous! My heart's fluttering just thinking about it. Were you going to make a deposit today? Folks come in all the time to withdraw gold, then turn around and lose it all betting on a game of tribute. Some big names, too. People you wouldn't believe. Oh, but I shouldn't say any more. What can I do for you?
Thank you. Can I help you with something? I'm listening. What's on your mind? You're affable enough. Just be honest with me and we'll get along fine. What can I do for you?
My friend Hyduna wants to set me up with some old pirate that's been frequenting her inn. Can you imagine? A pirate and a banker! How ridiculous! My heart's fluttering just thinking about it. Were you going to make a deposit today? I know I won't have to look far to find him.
My only regrets are things I haven't done yet, so I prefer to think of them as goals. Always ready to help.
You're better off over-prepared to fight than under. If you can travel the island in numbers, even better.
Is there something I can do? I'm listening. What's on your mind? I love the life of an adventurer, but I also find joy in simple things. Playing my flute, reading a good book. I'm fascinated by history and magecraft, but I also love a good tale, well spun. How can I help?
These sea elf pirates become more brazen every day. When is House Mornar going to do something?
You know, House Dufort never has these problems on High Isle.
That's not entirely true. There are those incidents with the Ascendant Order.
Into the bushes.
Quakes as her song is heard. Waves crash and boil at her feet. This mountain won't bend in defeat. Volcano spirit weaves life from her loom. Where fires burn, flowers now bloom. Where earth once cracked, Isle grows, clear skies cut through thick smoke's plume. At dawn's break, we sing her praise, and new life grows from molten bed. As birds emerge from the haze, her spirit will last beyond our days. Volcano spirit weaves life from her loom. Where fires burst, flowers now bloom. Where earth once cracked, the isle grows. Clear skies cut through thick smoke's plume.
Ha ha ha.
Our toes along the streets,
and we never Hello there. Think to fear.
A dance is always welcome in the city of Bastyr. From sparkling docks to Castle Morn, all good people far and near. You'll never be without a friend in the city of Bastyr. Bastyr, Bastyr, gale and shining gem, Bastyr, Bastyr, rise above the waves, Bastyr, Bastyr, hear its melody, Bastyr, Bastyr, city with a song. Go have a drink at the Jaded Ornog, and your worries disappear. Druids and nobles and peasants are all
I'll be just a step behind you.
In the city of Bastyr, along the sister's lovely coast, to our shores we hope you fear.
Always carry a weapon. Even if you don't know how to use it, people might think twice before trying to cross you.
I love a good pair of gloves. No, wait. A belt. Yes, a good belt, or perhaps boots? Yes, big, thick boots. No, belt. That's my final answer.
Unfamiliar magic is like drinking strange wine. Eventually, there will be a price to pay.
Above the waves, Bastyr, Bastyr, hear its melody, Bastyr, Bastyr, city with the song.
By the looks of you, I imagine you're here about the handbills posted around the city. Does that mean you're up for the dangerous work House Mernard is offering? No, I oversee their dispersal. Lady Juline and the Druids, Gastok and Aishabe can tell you about specific jobs that are available. Each tend the wilds in their own way, but they all benefit Galen and have been approved by House Mernard. Getting the lay of the land before starting a campaign? I can respect that. What would you like to know? Galen is no stranger to volcanic activity. Lava vents across the island are spewing forth molten rock and savage creatures. Druid Aishabe knows more. She advises forming a group to tackle these vents. Druid Gastok represents the Stonemore Circle. He's got a mean look and meaner tasks, but he's a nice fellow once you get to know him. If his stories about terrible foes are true, you'll want to bring along a capable party. She's a curious one. Lady Juline wants to make a tour of the island's sites. She needs lone explorers to secure the route. I think she underestimates the dangers, but if she wants to spend coin to make the wild safer, I won't stop her. If you've got the steel to work alone, talk to Juline Crossell. If you don't mind cooperating with other sellswords, I hear Druid Gastok and Druid Aishabe have some dangerous work. And take this, a gift from the house, for your aid. Juline Crossell has jobs for a lone sellsword. For Druid Gastok and Druid Aishabe's tasks, you will need the aid of some hardy companions. They all pay well, and I can also offer the thanks of House Mernard. Indeed, it's been an honor serving House Mernard, first as a scout and soldier, and now as a recruiter finding adventurers like yourself for dangerous assignments. The work we do here benefits Galen and all its people. Of course I am. Some may find fault with the house's recent history, but I wholeheartedly believe the Count will steer us into a new age of prosperity, and the aid of adventurers such as you will secure this future.
Thank you.
my friend Hyduna wants to set me up with some old pirate that's been frequenting her inn. Can you imagine? A pirate and a banker? How ridiculous! My heart's fluttering just thinking about it. Were you going to make a deposit today?
Anything I can do for you?
I know I won't have to look far to find a man who'd treat me better than my last husband. Oh, but I stand here all day looking at Chethkasi and... oh, it's enough to make a woman wonder. Oh, I'm sorry. What can I help you with today? Folks come in all the time to withdraw.
Let's go find a problem to solve, and maybe get paid for it.
Folks come in all the time to withdraw gold, then turn around and lose it all betting on a game of tribute. Some big names, too. People you wouldn't believe. Oh, but I shouldn't say any more. What can I do for you?
Close to her trembling words, the ground quakes as her song is heard. Waves crash and boil at her feet. This mountain won't bend in defeat. Volcano spirit weaves life from her loom, where fires burst. Flowers now bloom where earth once cracked. The isle grows. Clear skies cut through thick smoke's plume. At dawn's break, we sing her praise. A new life grows from molten bed. As birds emerge from the haze, her spirit will last beyond our days. Volcano spirit weaves life.
Julien Cressel has jobs for a lone sellsword. For Druid Gastok and Druid Aishabe's tasks, you will need the aid of some hardy companions. They all pay well, and I can also offer the thanks of House Bernard. No, I oversee their dispersal. Lady Julien and the Druids Gastok and Aishabe can tell you about specific jobs that are available. Each tend the wilds in their own way, but they all benefit Galen and have been approved by House Bernard. Getting the lay of the land before starting a campaign? I can respect that. What would you like to know? Galen is no stranger to volcanic activity. Lava vents across the island are spewing forth molten rock and savage creatures. Druid Aishabe knows more. She advises forming a group to tackle these vents. Druid Gastok represents the Stonelore Circle. He's got a mean look and meaner tasks, but he's a nice fellow once you get to know him. If his stories about terrible foes are true, you'll want to bring along a capable party. She's a curious one. Lady Julien wants to make a tour of the island's sights. She needs lone explorers to secure the route. I think she underestimates the dangers, but if she wants to spend coin to make the wild safer, I won't stop her. Indeed, it's been an honor serving House Bernard. First as a scout and soldier, and now as a recruiter finding adventurers like yourself for dangerous assignments. The work we do here benefits Galen and all its people. Of course I am. Some may find fault with the house's recent history, but I wholeheartedly believe the Count will steer us into a new age of prosperity. And the aid of adventurers such as you will secure this future.
It's good to be back. Guards, would you be so kind as to open the gates? I bring fresh fighters for the games.
You ain't allowed in here, Tallris. You know that.
I brought you some new competitors. Surely you can make an exception. Now, be a good lad and open the gates.
I'll be the judge of it. Let's see if they've got the right stuff. Durzog's attack!
That's your answer. Now, kindly open the gates. That's a good man.
Yes, that'll do. Open the gates!
Maybe tough enough for I smash you to bits!
Over here. Challengers appear from the cold wastes. Are they worthy enough to face the pack?
Can I help you?
Thank you.
most exotic and dangerous beasts from the dark corners of Tamriel to test these challenges! The first monstrosities presented for your entertainment come from the ashlands of Morrowind. These creatures laid waste to an entire village before I captured them. Without further ado, it is my great honor to present a magically corrupted strain of shock. I call them Incineration Beetles!
Thank you.
Yes?
By what you carry away from it.
Most people find the leather curing process to be quite smelly, but me? I find it comforting. Reminds me of making small pouches with my father when I was a kid.
Ah, a traveler bold enough to approach Gastok without a hint of fear. Now that is the sort of metal I'm looking for. And if you're looking for work, I've got as much gold to give you as Galen's got troubles. Oh, by the tide, am I glad you asked. I've got an urgent job from the north side of Galen, best handled in a group. A forest wraith has taken a group of hirelings under House Mornard captive, but there is still time to save them. Head to the Valley of the Watcher. The captives are bound in roots that feed off their life essence, but this tincture should weaken them enough to slough right off. And don't forget, you'll still need to contend with the hostile wraith. This is what happens when those who spend too much time on Galen get too comfortable with the dangers that lurk here. Mind that you don't repeat that to the mother that begged me to save her son, if you go speak to her. But it is true. Have you ever used an axe to fell a tree? Used that wood to craft armor, maybe a weapon itself? Imagine if, upon your first stroke of the axe, the tree you were aiming for struck back. That is what forest wraiths are. When needs call for it, spirits of the forest can facilitate druid magic to meld man and tree. Some among us willingly submit to such an honor. What results is a twisted guardian that has the strength and spirit of both, but the wisdom of neither. If you hear it scream, ready your weapon at once. After that, beware of shifting ground and deceptive magic. Once a wraith has identified you as a threat, there is no convincing the angry spirit that pilots these beings otherwise. Vastyr and all its inhabitants are part of this once untamed island, for better or worse. We Stonelore druids seek harmony through common ground with one another. But the same can't be said of the other circles. Will fire ever create instead of destroy? Will the tides ever change their rhythm? Mountains may flatten, waiting for such a change. But it is not impossible, my friend. Nothing ever is.
Dread sails are getting bolder these days. Seems like someone should do something about it.
Come and take us!
Trail.
test our steel!
Hello?
That should come in handy.
I was starting to lose feeling in my legs. Thank you.
Mother's going to be worried sick about me.
Hello.
Let's ride.
Like you before.
Great. I mean, same. Meeting a sea elf like you, that is.
This is a great area for harvesting.
Yeah.
people far and near. You'll never be without a friend in the city of Bastir.
Ah, back at last. I was starting to get nervous for you. And I've just finished drying the client's tears from my robes. Her son had to pull her off of me. I hope you'll excuse me if I show a bit more restraint in showing my thanks to you.
Plenty of customers forego helmets when buying a set of armor. It's all the same to me. No use in protecting your head if you're not even using it.
I know I won't have to look far to find a man who'd treat me better than my last husband. Oh, but I stand here all day looking at Chethkasi and... oh, it's enough to make a woman wonder. Oh, I'm sorry. What can I help you with today? My friend Hyduna wants to set me up with some old pirate that's been frequenting her inn. Can you imagine? A pirate and a banker! How ridiculous! My heart's fluttering just thinking about it. Were you going to make a deposit today? I know I won't have to look far to find a man who'd treat me better than my last husband. Oh, but I stand here all day looking at Chethkasi and... oh, it's enough to make a woman wonder. Oh, I'm sorry. What can I help you with today?
These sea elf pirates become more brazen every day. When is House Mornar going to do something?
You know, House Dufort never has these problems.
As weary as I feel, dear. I don't know how this sea air does anybody any good. Rest a while before a gust from the port knocks you over.